السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Scholar of renown, سفيان ابن عيينة, edited by عادل فضاحي. سفيان ابن عيينة الهلالي was born in Kufa in 107 after Hijra, corresponding to Common Era 725. Thus, he belonged to the third Islamic generation. He is quoted to have said that he met 87 of the successors to the Prophet's companion. He apparently met all the founders of the four schools of thought. He reports that it was Abu Hanifa who first placed him in a position of teaching. He arrived in Kufa when he was about 20 years of age. When Abu Hanifa saw him, he said to his student, "Now you have here the knowledge of Amr ibn Dinar." People began flocking to him, asking about Amr, who was the main scholar in Makkah. We have reports suggesting that Sufyan met Imam Malik at least twice, once in Medina and the other in Makkah. In Medina, Sufyan sought Malik and visited him. Malik received him well and praised his knowledge. On the other hand, both As-Safi and Ahmad ibn Anbal read under Sufyan and were among his students. Although Sufyan ibn Uyayna was born in Kufa in southern Iraq, he was soon to move to Makkah, where he lived most of his life. In Makkah, he attended the circles of many scholars and met many of the scholars of other places who visited the city for pilgrimage. He was keen to attend the famous scholars such as Al-Juhri and Amr ibn Dinar. He was indeed the youngest student of Al-Juhri, whom he says arrived in Makkah in the year 1203, and Sufyan attended him when he was only 16. On the other hand, he attended Amr ibn Dinar's circle for several years. But perhaps the main influence on Sufyan ibn Uyayna's scholarly life was his father, who directed him to scholarship ever since he was a young boy, helping him to memorize the Quran when he was only a boy 7 years of age. Some scholars have included Sufyan ibn Uyayna among the Hanafi scholars, but the fact is that he did not belong to the Hanafi school of thought. When he visited Kufa and met Abu Hanifa, the Hanafi school was still in its early stages. He soon returned to Makkah, where he was away from the scholarly atmosphere of Iraq. Indeed, Sufyan ibn Uyayna belongs to the scholars of Hadith. On the other hand, the Safi scholars consider him as one of the main influences on their school of thought, as Imam As-Safi was his student. Apparently, Sufyan ibn Uyayna learned from the best scholars. We have already mentioned that he was a young boy of 7 when he learned the Quran by heart. He also read the Quran under the top scholar of Quranic recitation in Makkah, Abdullah ibn Khathir. Abdullah ibn Khathir Dari, who was world famous as one of the 7 methods of recitation, that is Qiraat, is known after him. Sufyan ibn Uyayna must have read under him a few years before his death in 120. When Sufyan was only 13 years of age. One story which sums up Sufyan ibn Uyayna's gift as a scholar is that in which he describes his first meeting with Amr ibn Dinar, the top scholar of Hadith in Makkah. When he went to the mosque for Zuhr prayer, I saw at the door an old scholar mounting a donkey. He said to me, "Young lad, hold this donkey for me until I go into the mosque and pray." I said, "I will not do that unless you teach me some hadith." He felt that I was too young for that and said, "Well, what will you do with hadith?" I insisted and he related to me 8 hadith. I held his donkey for him and tried to memorize the hadith. When he finished his prayer and came out, he said, "What have you done with what I related to? You only held me back from my prayer." I related to him all 8 hadith. He said, "God bless you. Come tomorrow to this circle." That was Amr ibn Dinar. After this, Sufyan ibn Uyayna kept very close to Amr ibn Dinar for about 4 years, during which he learned from him most of what he related of hadith. Similarly, he learned much of what Az-Zuhri related. He was a close companion of Az-Zuhri for about a year towards the end of the latter's life. Yet scholars of hadith considered him one of the most accurate reporters of Az-Zuhri's hadith. He was perhaps his youngest student, having met him first at the age of 16. No doubt, his sharp memory and his youth were of immense value for him at the time, together with the close companionship of both Az-Zuhri and Amr ibn Dinar. Sufyan ibn Uyayna started teaching hadith when he was 35. Apparently, that was an early time for scholars of hadith. He reports that the first one to place him in a position of teaching hadith in the mosque was Misar ibn Kidam. He protested his young age for what was the custom at the time. Misar explained, "You have learned the hadith from both Az-Zuhri and Amr ibn Dinar." When Sufyan ibn Uyayna was a young man of 19, he travelled to Kufa, where he met many of his scholars, including Abu Hanifa, as mentioned earlier. He paid several visits to Kufa, where he always tried to meet scholars and learn from them. It is reported that Al-Ama, a famous scholar and reciter of the Quran, once asked him about the hadith related in Hijaz. Sufyan ibn Uyayna suggested that they exchange teaching one hadith for another. Thus, Sufyan would teach Al-Ama one hadith, then Al-Ama would teach him one in return. On a later visit, Sufyan suggested that they resume that arrangement. But Al-Ama complained of dearth of reporting and suggested that Sufyan could be more generous and offer 2 hadith for one by Al-Ama. He also travelled to Baghdad and Yemen, where he met Ma'an ibn Zayda, the local governor. He spoke to him at length, recommending a lenient approach of government. He apparently admonished him strongly that he should take good care of his Muslim subjects. Ma'an asked, are you their father? Are you their brother? We do not have any book written by Sufyan ibn Uyayna surviving in original form. We know, however, that he wrote a book of commentary on the Quran. Recently, some of the commentary and explanation attributed to Sufyan ibn Uyayna were collected, edited, and produced in a book published by Al-Maktabul Islami of Beirut and Usama Bookshop in Riyadh. A collection of hadith is also attributed to Sufyan, but probably it was collected by students, not written by him. However, Sufyan ibn Uyayna is ranked among the top scholars of hadith in the early period, prior to the time of the six well-known main collections of hadith. He was also well-known for his wise statements, which soften hearts and make people more willing to try hard to do their religious duties and avoid everything that God has prohibited. Sufyan ibn Uyayna died in 1908 after Hijra, corresponding to Common Era 814, at the age of 91, according to the lunar calendar. His nephew, Al-Hasan ibn Umran ibn Uyayna, reports that he went to pilgrimage with his uncle Sufyan in 1907. When we arrived in Muzdalifa, after attending at Arafat and my uncle completed his prayer, he lied down to sleep. He said to me, I have been in this place 70 times, meaning that he was offering the pilgrimage every year for 70 years. Every year I said in my supplication, my Lord, do not make this my last visit to this place. Now I feel ashamed that I should make this request again. He died that year before it was time for the next pilgrimage. Sufyan ibn Uyayna was buried at Al-Hajun, where Al-Muhalla graveyard is situated in Makkah. May God bless his soul. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.